Let us now discuss the effect of placing a thin transparent film in YDSC in front of any of the slit. Here you can see this is a typical YDSC setup in which at the screen center the two light waves which are traveling equal paths from slits S1 and S2. The path difference is equal to 0, so this will be the central bright fringe where intensity is maximum. And this is the point where a bright fringe is obtained due to constructive interference. Now, in this situation, say in front of one of the slit, if we place a thin transparent film like a cellophane sheet we are placing, which is having a thickness T and its refractive index is taken as mu. Then in this situation, even at point O, when the two light waves are reaching, from S2 it is directly reaching and from S1 it is reaching after passing through the transparent film. And certainly as the speed of light is less in this medium, this light will get delayed and the light from S2 will be ahead in path with respect to the wave which is coming from S1. Certainly here in this situation, after placing the film, the path difference at point O will not be equal to 0, and as if this is a medium of refractive index mu and the path is T, then for these two waves we can directly write the path difference can be given as T multiplied by mu minus 1. As in previous sections we have already discussed that the optical path difference introduced due to the travel of a light wave in a denser medium is given as T mu, because light from S2 is traveling a distance T and the light from S1 which is passing through the transparent media, it is traveling an equivalent path in air, that is mu T. So the difference will be T multiplied by mu minus 1. Now if we know the path difference at point O, we can find out the phase difference at point O, which is given by 2 pi by lambda multiplied by the path difference T into mu minus 1. And if you know the phase difference at point O, resulting intensity can be given as which is I at center of a screen is 4 I naught cos square phi naught by 2, if phi naught is the phase difference at point O, which is the screen center. This is the way how you can find out the intensity. Now, in parallel, as the path difference at point O is not 0, if we wish to locate the point on a screen where path difference is 0, then we can state that point will be located at somewhere above the center of a screen. And why this is so, you can understand that at this point, the distance traveled by the light wave coming from slit S2 is more and that traveled by slit S1 is less. And it can be such that the path difference between S1 and S2 physically at point P, if it is located at a distance x0, then at point P physical path difference we can write as dx0 by capital D, which we already discussed. This is the physical path difference. If this is exactly equal to the path difference which is introduced due to the placement of this film, then the path which is delayed in the wave coming from a slit S1 is exactly equal to the extra path which the wave coming from S2 is traveling in reaching point P. So this is the point where if physical path difference is dx0 by d, and if this is equal to the path difference due to the sheet which is T multiplied by mu minus 1, then we can state if this will happen, this implies path difference at point P is 0. Or we can say when this film was not present, the center of a screen will be having a bright fringe which we can call a central bright fringe or central maxima. As soon as we place a film, the whole fringe pattern will shift upward by a distance x0, so that the central maxima reaches this point P, which is such that dx0 by d is T into mu minus 1, and this is the point where now the path difference is 0. So here we can write if central maxima is shifted to point P, This implies we are using dx0 by ds t multiplied by mu minus 1. So the shift of central maxima here we can write dt mu minus 1 by small d. This is the distance by which not only central maxima, the whole fringe pattern will shift. So this is the shift of fringe pattern, which is due to the introduction of a thin film in the path of one of the slit. In the path of light waves which are coming from one of the slit. Let us now continue our discussion on live shift of fringe pattern due to introduction of a thin film in YDSE. Here you can see this is a typical YDSE setup on which when a slit plane is illuminated by an incident light beam, fringe pattern is obtained on the screen. And here, if we talk about the center of a screen, as the light waves from the two slits are traveling equal paths, so the path difference at the screen center is zero and the maximum intensity is produced and a bright fringe is obtained with intensity 4I0 at the center. Now here, if we carefully place a transparent thin film in front of slit S1, here you can see the whole fringe pattern will shift in upward direction. In such a way that the central maxima is shifted to a point P, which is located at a distance x, such that the path difference introduced by the thin film, which is t multiplied by mu minus 1 in the path of one of the light beam, is compensated by the physical path difference in the light waves approaching to point P, which is given by dx by capital D. So, in this situation here, the value of x, we already calculated this given as dt multiplied by mu minus 1 by small d. This is the distance by which the central maxima is shifted, or this is the shift of fringe pattern. Here you can see, if we remove the thin film and we place it in the path of a second slit or in front of second slit, you can see the fringe pattern will shift in downward direction because now the point where central maxima will be located, that is the point of zero path difference, will be below the center of screen because now the path of light wave which is coming from S2 is delayed because of this thin film. So when S1 distance is more from point P, then only the path difference will be compensated.